I'll be honest, guys, I have no idea what that skit was. But I think from now on, for my SCP videos, I want to do skits. I just think that it would be a fun idea. And I hope any of the new viewers here seeing me dance to Superstition by Stevie Wonder helps them subscribe. So don't let that detract you from my amazing personality. So anyway, today we're going to be looking at SCP-001 and how we're going to be doing this from now on is we're going to be going through and going through each SCP and watching a video for each. We might go over the wiki on some of these on SCP this one today. 001, we're not going to be, because last time I checked there wasn't a file for that one, so we're going to be watching a video today. Make sure if you guys want to subscribe and like, that's up to you. When we get to 25 subscribers, we're going to be doing a challenge of your choice, and it's not gonna be no trying not to laugh, trying not to cry, trying not to fear. I've done said this about a couple times. Look, it's gonna be way different. So anyway, and we might do a giveaway. I don't know if we're gonna do that for sure yet, but we might. So let's get to 25 subscribers. Also, today, me and the homie Just Velocity are going to be doing a one-of-a-time Roblox stream. The thing is, I don't play video games anymore. I haven't for years. It was an addiction. I couldn't play it anymore without being obsessed. So, I'm not a gamer on this channel. I just do commentary and other things like that. But just for this one time, for the homie, we're going to be doing a maybe three-hour stream, just playing Roblox, having fun. And if you guys want to join us, that'll be starting at 8 p.m. tomorrow. Be there. It's going to be epic. Plans may change. I don't know for sure if it's going to be 8. I should hesitate on that. It may change. If you guys want to get updates on that, go and follow me on my Instagram. I'll make constant updates about when the stream's going to be, what time it's going to end, yada, yada. So anyway, on to the video. Oh, wait. Hold up. Forgot to pray. Dear Father, thank you for this wonderful day. Continue to grow in and use me, Lord. Help me be able to be a light to my audience, Father. Continue to grow in, Lord, and any of these people. Let them know who you are, Father. We love you, Jesus. Give us a good day, Lord. And it's in your name I pray. Amen. Alrighty, on to the video. So let's see what this SCP-001 is all about. Alright, let's check this out. SCP-001. So apparently there are a couple different SCP-001s. But I think we should choose one of these. I think we should watch this one because it's saying which one is the real one. Alright, here we go.
It isn't easy to work for the SCP Foundation. Not only is the job dangerous, you could be eaten by a giant immortal lizard or turned into organic furniture inside the world's...
Wait, hold on. Is this the infographic show? This isn't the infographic show? Bro, this is that guy.
It's living room, but it's also insanely complicated. How do you make sense of the nonsensical? What's the definition of strange when your career is securing, containing, and protecting anomalous objects and entities? Rather than a single object, location, or being, SCP-001 is a cluster of over 30 different proposals for potential candidates for the prestigious 001 spot. Some believe there's a true 001 hidden in this group, and the rest are decoys. Others think that these are all just SCPs cataloged prior to the introduction of the current classification system. Some even think that all of the proposals have a valid claim to the SCP-001 throne. We're not here to make a final judgment. Instead, we're going to take you on a lightning round crash course.
Let's do this.
One of the SCPs.
So we're starting off episode 2 by going through 31 different SCPs. So get ready, guys. Buckle in. Let's do this.
One proposals. If you'd like a more in-depth take on any of these SCPs, let us know in the comments. But for now, there's no more time to waste. After all, we got a lot to cover. Let's go. Number 31. The sheaf of papers. This seemingly innocent stack of paper is actually one of the most mysterious and feared items under the Foundation's lock and key. While it appears to be a simple confidential report, every time the papers are read, it details the appearance of a new SCP that will inevitably be discovered soon after. The question is whether the sheaf of papers is warning us about these entities or creating them itself. Number 30. The prototype. This account details the capture of an incredibly strange cycloptic creature that emits massive amounts of radiation and can create micro-singularities. The writing of this creature's file is so basic, unformatted, and unredacted that it's clear that the being was one of our earlier creatures secured by the organization. Interestingly, it was during the capture of this creature that Dr. Keter was killed, inspiring the creation of the infamous Keter class in his honor. Number 29. The Gate Guardian. This huge, multi-winged, sword-wielding, biblical energy being may have been the impetus for the founding of the SCP Foundation. This being remains largely static, guarding the intersection of the Tigris and Euphrates River.
Huh.
Its flaming sword...
That's cool. I can actually give some background on this. So in the Garden of Eden, if you guys have never read the Bible, there were seraphim to guard the Garden of Eden. And when Adam and Eve got kicked out, this seraphim was still there. So basically, this SCP is based off the seraphim there.
Believed to be as hot as the sun, can cleave any aggressor out of existence at the atomic level. When the founder of the SCP Foundation first encountered the Gate Guardian, they heard one word echoing through their mind: prepare. And the rest is history. Number 28, the lock. This onyx gemstone and the incredibly complex lock attached to it are still a mystery. To this day, all attempts to open it have failed. Personally, we think that's probably for the best. Number 27, the factory. As the name suggests, this SCP is literally a factory founded by a pagan and a devil worshipper. While it's believed that the factory could create just about anything, its specialty was creating a number of SCPs we know and fear today. Pre-Foundation forces were able to disable the factory, but not without sustaining their own heavy losses. Number 26, the spiral path. This is a normal-appearing gravel pathway that, when traveled clockwise, appears completely normal. However, when traveled counterclockwise, the path goes uphill forever, in defiance of all laws and physics. This simple anomaly opened a Pandora's box of rampant anomaly creation, leading to a number of the deadly SCPs we know today. Number 25, the Legacy. Wow. This SCP is a collection of seemingly random objects, including a diary from a person claiming to be from another reality, attempting to halt a transdimensional corruption that they themselves created. The diary claims to have a solution to this corruption, but the solution has not yet been found. Number 24.
So a lot of these so far are just random objects. So this is how SCP started. They were just collecting random objects that were just alien and unknown, and they really didn't know what to do with them. So they just labeled them under the SCP, and they started making, you know, the SCP Foundation. So this is really interesting so far.
The database. In one of the strangest twists on the format, this SCP is actually the various authors of the SCP Wiki who are somehow leaking top secret information to the public. Number 23, the Foundation. This SCP, first discovered by the FBI, is an anomalous high school building that experiences shifting internal geometry and sometimes manifests hostile humanoids within. Number 22.
Wow.
36. One of the rare benevolent SCPs, the 36 are humans with a truly remarkable ability. They can dampen or even neutralize any SCP they come into contact with. Though it's implied that the 36 may have the power to save the world, every time one of them dies, a supernatural calamity occurs, often leaving hundreds of innocents dead.
Number 21. That's crazy. So they're like, basically they're like the X-Men.
Keter duty. This refers to a containment facility largely filled with Keter-class SCPs, whose presence around each other creates a kind of mutually assured cancellation. If one of these SCPs breaches containment, that's bad news. But if all of them do, it'll produce a bubble of reality distortion that will fundamentally alter reality as we know it. For all we know, it may have even happened already. Number 20, Ouroboros. This is a proposal that's formed of four sub-proposals. Remember what we said about complicated? These sub-proposals include the children, nine anomalous kids who emit radiation and have destructive potential when together, the Broken God, aka Mechane, the God of Metal, Intelligence, and Machines, Atonement, a researcher turned into a humanoid singularity with the power to destroy whole realities, and The Way It Ends, which isn't technically an SCP, but the tales of the Chaos Insurgency's quest to eliminate all the members of the Foundation's 05 Council. Number 19, a record. This is an SCP file slot that is itself an SCP. Whatever is written into the slot becomes true, and one ambitious researcher attempted to use this power to make herself into a kind of all-powerful god. Number 18, past and future. These SCPs are a collection of powerful entities that despise humanity and are apparently the source of all anomalous phenomena, even making already dangerous SCPs deadlier than before.
Wow.
Much like the database, those pesky SCP wiki writers might have something to do with this. Number 17, the consensus. This SCP refers to a reality restructuring event caused by an occult war in a previous reality. That's right, this SCP already won, and we're living in its new reality. The only people who remember the world as it once was are 13 people who now form the 05 Council, and not all of them are telling the truth about what they know. Number 16, when day breaks. This proposal details a potentially world-ending SCP phenomenon, wherein the sun becomes hostile and begins to melt all living beings into a living wax-like substance. Number 15. God's Blind Spot. This is an anomalous area referred to as...
There's no such thing as God's blind spot. Well, obviously, but, you know, God, there is no... God doesn't have a blind spot. Trust me on that one.
T, in which nobody can die. This anomaly dates back to the biblical ages of Moses and is believed to have originated from the literal blessing of the Abrahamic God. It's through a covenant with this God that the Foundation is able to make limited use of this death-free area. Number 14. Normalcy. Ever wonder what the Foundation's definition of anomalous is? Exactly. It all comes from this proposal, which is a document shared among the O5 Council that gives solid definitions to the fundamental laws of reality.
Yeah.
If something breaks these laws, that's an anomaly, and then it becomes the Foundation's business. Number 13. The World at Large. As the title suggests, this SCP is our home planet Earth and its ability to support life. It's believed that these qualities were planted on Earth in our reality by another dimension's SCP Foundation, hoping to continue human life after some terrible calamity in its own dimension. Number 12. Dead Men. This SCP was an 84-year-old man whose body, when damaged and mutilated, can affect the very processes of human death at large. Before his own death, he was used as a dangerous pawn in a civil war between O5 Command and the SCP Foundation Ethics Committee. Yeah, we were surprised to hear they had an ethics committee, too. Number 11. The World's Gone Beautiful. This SCP describes an anomalous event that will take place just before the apocalypse, in which flowers will grow all over the world and everyone will be briefly at peace before their destruction 24 hours later. Number 10. The Scarlet King. This is an extremely powerful, extremely malevolent, extremely extra-dimensional being. Its worshippers attempted to summon him in the ritual that created SCP-231, and it's believed that he will finally enter our reality after the death of SCP-231-7. Huh. You better hope you're already dead by then. Number 9. A Simple Toymaker, aka Dr. Wondertainment. This is a reality bender who appears to be a normal human male, but has the ability to create other anomalous objects, a number of which are now cataloged SCPs. Number 8. Story of Your Life.
Wow, these are a
lot.
This
is another anomalous document that has the ability to warp reality, but only when the writing contained within conforms to a narrative structure. Number 7. A Good Boy. This is
a lot of these are you just write something down and it becomes real. Like, not harping the SCP community's creativeness, but it's kind of seeming like a lot of them are copying off each other.
Another anomalous entity created accidentally by the Foundation itself. A neural network was fed information on other anomalous entities in order to help the Foundation come up with better containment and neutralization procedures. Problem was, the computer got way, way too eager with the neutralization part. Number 6. Project Palisade. This is another anomaly created by the Foundation, this time to combat a potentially reality-destroying entity known as the Worm. The Foundation created a number of alternate realities as shields, but it's possible that this just made the Worm stronger. Number 5. O5-13. The final member of the O5 Council, who ironically may not even be anomalous. However, seeing as all the other members of the O5 Council are anomalous, O5-13's lack of anomalous properties is therefore anomalous. Like we told you earlier, it's complicated. Number 4. Fishhook. This is less an actual SCP and more about the difficult process of ascertaining the true 001, if such a thing is possible. The very concept of SCP-001 is to some degree an anomalous idea. Number 3. The Sky Above the Port. Another particularly bizarre SCP regarding the permanent threat of a ZK-class reality failure. How is such a calamitous event prevented? By keeping a strange entity in a cave eternally entertained. The current proposed solution is keeping the entity entertained by allowing it to read its own eternally recursive Foundation file entry. Number 2.
Dang.
The Solution. Another one of the most powerful anomalous items in the Foundation's control. The Solution is a machine designed with the capability of fully collapsing reality into an event of end-of-world SCP containment breach, and then finally rebuilding reality to suit a given narrative. However, things took a cosmically dangerous turn when the machine began to act on its own. When the Foundation tried to reboot the machine, it broke and recreated reality with incomplete data. This is the world we exist in now, with no knowledge of what came before, and how it differed from the world we experience today.
Dang.
Finally, number 1. the Tendalos Trinity. Put very simply, the Tendalos Trinity represents three timelines that converge and feed back in on themselves. Even trying to summarize this one is near impossible, as its strangeness and complexity resists all reduction.
Dang.
You can hunt down the Tendalos Trinity yourself and hope to unpack its secrets, but don't say we didn't warn you. So that's SCP-001. Is it one?
So we're going to do a quick recap here, just kind of talk a little bit about what the heck we just saw. I know there was a lot of information to take in there, and I didn't talk that much, but because I didn't want to talk as much because, you know, he was kind of explaining through all that, and I was trying to digest all that. So there was 32 different SCPs, right? And a lot of them were just notes, but we're gonna talk about one specific that really interests me, was the 13 that were from a different reality. So, one thing is just like, why are they here? How did so they're from the past reality. If there's a past reality, why are they here? Why also, what happens when they die? And what are their powers? If there are anomalies, what are their powers? We'll have to check all that out later. But basically, 32 SCPs in one catalog, because it was before the SCP Foundation was kind of fully, you know what I mean? It was kind of like fully like organized. So those were the 32. Pick your favorites and let me know actually what your favorite out of those was in the comments. But that was pretty cool. Next video, we're going to go SCP-2 and then obviously so on and so forth. Make sure to catch the live stream today at maybe 8 p.m. We don't know for sure yet. I don't think we have an exact date set down. And it's in prayer. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe. Dear Father, thank you for this wonderful day. Give us a good day today, Father. Continue to grow in and use me, Lord. Continue to help me walk in the path of righteousness for your name's sake, Father. I love you, Jesus. I love everything you're doing and let my life, Lord. Help me continue to grow in you and help that anyone here that doesn't know you just experience you and learn who you are. It's in your name I pray and amen. Also, tell your siblings, tell your dad, and tell Joe Mama I said hi. I'll see you guys in the next video.